down. Preparation by do not reagent. Preparation of alkene by Grignard reagent. Next one, write down by write down Grignard reagent on reaction with vinyl halide. Grignard reagent on reaction with vinyl halide forms alkene with respect to Grignard reagent on reaction with vinyl halide forms alkene with respect to the alkyl group of Grignard reagent. The alkyl group of Grignard reagent. Suppose this is the Grignard reagent RMGX and this reacts with vinyl halide. This is vinyl halide, CH2 double bond CHX. This position is vinylic position, this carbon. This is vinylic position, vinylic carbon. If you attach OH here, we call it as vinyl alcohol. Right, one more position is there, CH2 double bond, CH single bond, CH2X. This carbon is allylic carbon. Okay, this one is allylic. The name of this compound is allylic halide.
So, you've done the same thing. So, both are the same, you just.
No, it's not. Three carbon. Yeah, pe double bonded carbon X.
So, is there a name for like.
For this position.
So the next position, if I would add another carbon, would be in.
No, it's not.
Okay,
so. It's not up here. It's not, there is no other thing. Okay, but this is not required for this reaction. But this position you must remember, this is allylic. Okay? Now what happens here, the product here is R CH double bond CH2 plus MgX2. This is the reaction. Okay? This R minus Mg2 plus and X minus, right? R minus attack onto this carbon atom, this goes out as X minus. And MgX minus takes this, forms MgX.
So what is preparation of alkenes?
We do kar rahe hain.
So already we have alkene. Oh no, this is alkene. It's not so good.
Wait sir, so then how the alkene also depends on the vinyl?
When you say vinyl halide, it means it is this. X can be good for chlorine bromine. But this is fixed. It means fixed.
So on that side, you can't have more.
No, this side you cannot have. This position is vinylic position. This group we call it as vinyl group. CH2 double bond, CH and one open ended. Vinyl. Okay? Right on next. Wittig reaction. Wittig, yeah, Wittig, yeah. Woods, Wittig, Woods, yeah, Wittig. This one we haven't done.
So this is this in the eye or is it like
maybe the eye? Right out. We'll finish this preparation. I think one more reaction is there. Wittig reaction, write down. Wittig reagent is.
So this is a different method. This is a different method of preparation.
Different method of preparation. Wittig reaction, write down. The Wittig reagent we use is alkylidene. Alkylidene. Triphenyl phosphorane. Triphenyl phosphorane. This is Wittig reagent. Sometimes they ask you this question, what is Wittig reagent? So alkylidene triphenyl phosphorane. Okay? The formula is PH3P triphenyl double bond CR2. Formula is This
so but yes.
So,
BH3 as in 3 in chain, like BH3?
Triphenyl. Triphenyl from attachment is possible.
So, like, will it be 3
benzene?
3 benzene, benzene, benzene.
No, it's not like that. Means it's attached with phosphorus. Benzene, benzene, benzene.
So,
benzene, benzene.
Alkylidine is Cr2 double bond.
Benzene from
two bond.
Yes, but that alkylidine is phosphorus, right? It's BH3. This R you see, this R we can take as hydrogen simply or any other alkyl. CH3 we can take, C2H5 we can take. The simplest one is when R is hydrogen. So this one is PH3P double bond CH. This is methylidine. CH2 double bond is methylidine. Okay.
CH2
double bond. This open double bond CH2. It's methylidine. Okay. Now the reaction is very simple. Suppose this is the method of preparation of alkene from aldehyde or ketone. What is this ketone? Now when this reacts with PH3P double bond CH2, the product of this reaction is CH3C double bond CH2 CH3 plus PH3P double bond.
So this is for ketones. We take reactions for ketones.
Ketones, aldehyde. Preparation of alkenes from aldehyde or ketone.
So what are they together called? Ketones and aldehyde?
Carbonyl compound.
So there also you just replace the double bond.
Double bond.
So we don't always use this, right? PH3PCH2.
Generally we use this only. But instead of this we can use, suppose CH3, 2 also we can use.
So basically
CR2
band.
Okay. Just what we have to do. This double bond, O and double bond CH2 you have to switch.
So ethene can't be found.
Ethene can't be found. Whatever we have here, this we should attach with this carbon.
So, why is it called phosphorine? Like, what's the phosphorine?
Phosphorine is anything when you have B double bond O group, B double bond O.
So, there's no B double bond O.
Double bond O is not there, B double bond is there. Double bonded phosphorus generally we call it as phosphorine. Okay, what is the product in this reaction? In this we do not have any exceptions. Mechanism is not there. We can discuss mechanism also, but that is not required. And since this is a main reaction, so reagent and pattern is always fixed. You don't have to do anything. No.
So in this one, the reaction is which ketone and all is more stable.
Sure, but like most
in this reaction,
the reactant So is it possible to say which one is stable?
I mean, I have.
This one is more stable.
In general, see, okay, guys, listen to me one thing. We haven't done the percentage composition of keto in all group. Right? For that, we have 5-6 methods. Okay. That we'll discuss. That one and one more thing. Conformers, cyclohexane. That we'll discuss after finishing this chapter. Okay? Like in this one, you see, here we have tautomerism possible, keto in all. This converts into this. in general, what happens, keto form is more stable than enol form. Enol form. Why? Because C double bond O bond is stronger than this carbon-carbon double bond. So in this one, you have to compare, then this is more stable. But if you take this, there are some, you know, rules for this. If you take this one, here also keto-enol tautomerism is possible. Right? And it converts into double bond O, and this converts into phenol. This one is what? Aromatic. So since it is aromatic, highly stable, so this 100% this converts into this. So its composition is 100%.
So phenol-emitting reaction won't take place.
Which one? This reaction? I'm not talking about this reaction.
No, so but it
in
won't
this
take
it won't take. Because it is a reaction of only aldehyde and ketone. Conversion of aldehyde and ketone into alkene.
So in that first example,
this one,
shouldn't it have been C double bond C CH?
No, it's not. R, this R can be hydrogen or alkyl, anything. That's why you see this entire group is attached to this double bond.
Yes, sir. So, but then over there, why did the full thing go?
Well, full thing did go.
Oh, yeah, no, it did. Yeah.
Okay, write down one last reaction by co-elimination reaction. Write down the last one by. Co-elimination reaction. Write down. In this reaction, three degree amine oxide with at least one amine oxide with at least one beta hydrogen is heated at 150 degrees Celsius. In this 3 degree amine oxide with at least one beta hydrogen, is heated at 150 degrees Celsius and it forms an alkene. It forms alkene and a derivative of hydroxylamine. RCH H CH2 N double bond O, R2.
It is not possible. Then you call for a dance. You try to the dance.
So what is that compound?
This is a 3D amine oxide and double bond. It has 5 electrons in the
So it doesn't have
this one. Only phosphorus can form 5 bonds. So I saw some questions in which nitrogen became pentavalent directly with it.
So these two have an
MPG. So we can write this way.
Yeah, so break the bond.
Huh? So actually, you see this one, simply we are heating it. So if you write this reaction this way, carbon, hydrogen, beta carbon is this, alpha and beta. So when you heat this, this bond, lone pair takes this hydrogen, this comes over here and this goes over. So it forms this product. RCH double bond CH2 NR2OH. Okay? So must require at least one beta hydrogen for this reaction. At beta position, we must have at least one hydrogen so that this hydrogen is taken up by this O minus and forms hydroxyl acid. Okay, finished. We'll take a break. Preparation is done. We'll see some chemical reactions after this. We have a reaction with peroxide.